For those of you who noticed I was gone, I am back. For those of you who didn't, I'm just here again. What is up, everyone? Y'all ready for this one? It isn't every day that you find hip-hop songs that throw you off, but when you do, well, that's a reason for a party.
זה לא עובד באנגלית, אה? לא.
Anyhow, these two songs have a similar concept, where the hi-hat manipulates the way we hear the beat. Bring that hi-hat over. Does this thing still work?
Ah, still good.
This first song is by the awesome Israeli hip-hop band Adag Nachash, and the song is called Akafa Metzeltzelet, which, nah, I'm not gonna try writing that in English. I'll just link to the song in the description.
Now remember, before I play the song, in a drum groove, the hi-hat is the one that is in charge of perception. So let's say, for example, I'm gonna play a kick and snare pattern that looks like this. I can place the hi-hat here and we get this groove. Or I can place the hi-hat here and we get a totally different groove. Remember, I didn't change the pattern at all. I just changed the way it's presented, so the way you perceive it.
Okay, so I'll play the song, and you try and find the pulse as quickly as you can, and clap it, or snap it, or count it, whatever. I'll wait. You got it? So this is how the kick and snare pattern looks like. Kick would be blue, and snare would be pink. And yes, I got permission from Sharon to say this. And the hi-hat is placed here, which, at a first listen, threw me off to hear it as a downbeat. Like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. But the vocals sound kind of off, and when the chorus hits, I mean, just listen to this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Oh. Long story short, this is what the beat actually looks like. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, chorus entrance. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So if these are the downbeats, that means that the hi-hat plays on upbeat eighth notes all the way. Pretty sneaky.
I fear you're underestimating the sneakiness, sir.
I love this song. It's an awesome track from an even awesomer album. You should go listen. Okay, next. This song, while it may be simple for some of you, it can also be kinda difficult for others.
So let me know in the comments if you got it in the first try. Am I doing it right? Okay. Pro YouTuber.
Oh boy. Well, take a listen and try and tell me what the time signature is. This one is called A Fresh Pair of Panties by Snoop Dogg. Yet another lovely title.
Yes, I have a typo. It's supposed to be double G. I'm an idiot. Let's just move on.
It's time to slow it down, steadily grinding. And this is the big doggy dog.
And I ain't talking about no Air Force Ones. I just gotta know before you let me get some.
While this may be simple for some, I've played this song many times in my polyrhythm classes, and the amount of different answers I got was pretty large.
How do we find time signatures? What do we look for? We look for patterns, or we look for some leading pulse that can arrange the music in a way that makes sense to us rhythmically. Now, yes, as drummers, we tend to hear music through the drum lens. So your answers may vary according to what instrument you play. And I assume that mostly drummers watch this channel. Who are you guys? Let me know, because I don't really know and I'm actually very curious.
Anyway, this groove kinda looks like this. And the first tempting version to hear this groove through, and actually the version most of my students, who are mostly drummers, actually heard, was this, in 5. By the way, the crossed yellow circles would be the added count, as opposed to that single hi-hat that is a part of the groove. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. So the ending on this one sounded, not amazing. But the logic behind this was that the kick, snare, and hi-hat are all equal downbeats. But doesn't really work. The next version also almost makes sense. And it's an 11, divided as 4, 3, and 4. A few of my students heard it this way, and honestly, it's wrong, but it's pretty cool. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, So in the 5, it was on beat 2, and in the 11, it was on beat 3. That's not necessarily the case. And also, the keys and vocals didn't really lock into anything.
Wrong.
But the winner of all is, of course, 4-4. I mean, it's hip-hop, come on, did you really think it would be something else? Here's the real beat count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
And this is the big doggy dog.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
I just gotta know.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And notice that when listening like this, that hi-hat isn't placed on a downbeat. Rather, it's an anticipated 16th note before beat 2. And if we add a regular steady hi-hat pulse on it, it all makes perfect sense.
Steadily grinding. And this is the big doggy dog.
And I ain't talking about no Air Force Ones.
It may make more sense if I play it on the drums. Catch this.
So, just for the sake of experimenting, I'm gonna go through all three versions and listen to the vocals and the keys and how they sound different through each one of these interpretations.
And I ain't talking about no Air Force Ones. I just gotta know before you let me get some.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Do you have a fresh pair of panties on?
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Finally, I want to thank my patrons on Patreon. Patreon is a platform where people like you can help people like me keep our channels running. As you know, or not, all these videos that I make get demonetized very quickly, as I use copyrighted material, obviously, and YouTube doesn't really like that. So if you feel the urge to help me out with this channel, find my Patreon page at patreon.com/yogevgabay. I thank you very much, and I'll see you guys soon.